What's going on, guys? Welcome back to a new video. So I have got the Chromecast with Google TV in front of me. I got this yesterday. I spent the whole day setting this up, getting it unboxed, getting all my apps on there from different regions, etc. As you know, here in the UK, we really have a crap choice of applications and subscription services to use. So I spent the whole day yesterday getting this device set up to my liking. I went for the sunrise colour, which is basically this. Now, this is what you are used to seeing when you see a Google Chromecast. This year, they've completely revamped the way that these things work, and they've give you a remote with the Chromecast for the first time ever. I went for this colour simply because I've never had a streaming device that isn't in your standard black or white colour. They do a blue version as well, but I thought I'd go for this colour. It's a really nice muted colour. It's not girly. I'd say this is a deeper pink. This is very pale. It's not white. You can see that it's not white. The button here matches the colour of the device itself. The rest of the device is like a very pale pink. Google have put some incredible attention to detail in there, and they've even give you colour-coded batteries. So if you get the white Chromecast, you'll get white batteries. If you go for the blue one, I believe you get blue batteries. They've included some pink batteries with this just to make it a nicer experience when you're setting this up, and I think that's a nice touch. I also picked up this extra device here. This was £20, which is quite expensive, but in this area that I'm filming, which is where I watch 90% of my TV shows and movies, I have terrible internet service, terrible Wi-Fi, should I say. So I picked up this Ethernet adapter, and it's basically just your standard plug, your standard USB-C connector, only you have got an Ethernet port on there as well, where you plug it in. Never seen anything like this before. I believe they did do this for the last Chromecast, and they maybe do it for their Chromebooks as well. I'm not sure, I've never used one, but I thought that is a fantastic idea. So I'm going to go and get this plugged in, and I will show you just how it runs. Right, guys, so I've got this hooked up now. I already set this up yesterday, so I'm not going to show you any of that. Really simple process. You can either sign in with your email and password using the remote, or you can use your Google Home app on your smartphone and just scan the QR code and follow the steps to sign in. So this is what you're going to see once you get this device up and running. These things at the top here, these are obviously strategically placed by Google. They will have advertisement deals in place, and this will change by the week or the day, or whenever something big comes out, you'll expect to see them advertising it here. You can't change that. Underneath that are some recommendations for top picks. So again, these will change by the more that you use the movies and the TV show tabs. And by that, I mean, for instance, selecting movies from here, letting them know that you've watched it, and then rating it with a thumbs up or a thumbs down. It will let the Google algorithm know what exactly you like to watch and what you don't like to watch, and it will then categorize things, whether it be something that has the same actors in, the same director, and it will recommend that to you on a different day. So I actually think it's a good idea. A lot of people might not like this. They might think it's a bit heavy, a bit intrusive, but I actually like it. So as you can see, some of these things here have a padlock next to it and a price. So that is letting you know that this isn't available on the streaming services that you are logged in on. And by that, I mean the streaming services that it will let you know that you are logged in on depends on the account you are logged into. So as you can see, I've actually got HBO Max, Peacock, etc., which are all US-based streaming services. So because I'm logged in on my UK account, it will not give me the option to add that. And by that, I mean at the bottom here, this get better recommendations. they're the only services that it will let me let them know that I'm using. If I was logged into my American account, I would then be able to select HBO, Peacock, etc. It would let me let them know that I'm using them. But because I'm logged into my UK main account, unfortunately, I can't do that. It's not a big deal because I can just go into the apps and find stuff to watch anyway. But take that into consideration when you're deciding which account you want to use on this device. If everything you use is on the American apps, then you're just best off staying logged in on your American account. So the options that it gave me there was only to rent it or to buy it directly from Google. These shows here, basically, these are all on Amazon Prime. So if you go on that, you can see how many seasons there is, the cast and crew, and you can just go straight into Prime Video and watch it straight from there. If you change your mind, just go back to your home screen. It's going to take you back where you was. So like I said, I think this is a really good idea. I like it. I know a lot of people don't use any streaming services and they just sideload apps, but it's a good way to keep track of anything that you'd like to watch anyway. And by doing that, you can add things to your watch list. So by that, I mean this, add that to your watch list, go back to the home page. At the top, if you go to library, it then adds it to your watch list. So usually I would use like the IMDb app or something, and I would just find a movie that I wanted to watch, add it to that, and then when I've got the time to watch a film, I'll just sit there, scroll through the app and find what I want to watch, and then have to go to the device to look for it. This is actually a good idea because it's just on the device. It's not just specifically from one place, like these are all on the Google store, this is on Netflix, this is on Prime Video, etc. So it just puts everything in one place. And obviously, if you've made any purchases from the Google library as well, they will all appear in this section here, be it films or TV shows. It will just categorize it all. So yeah, good idea. For people who don't actually like this and feel like they wouldn't use it, you can turn it off and use this device in apps only mode. So by doing this, if you go to your account settings and you scroll over to the right, and there's an option called apps only mode. So if you switch this on, press continue, and then go to your home screen, you just get the one tab. You still get the adverts at the top. There is no way of getting rid of them, unfortunately. But then the only options you have is to use your apps that you've loaded onto your device. That's it. You've got your home tab and obviously your settings tab. Other than that, everything that I've just shown you previously is gone. This is obviously a good idea for anyone who's got kids and they don't want their kids accidentally purchasing things, adding stuff to their watch list, etc. Or even if you share your account with your kids and they watch a lot of kids stuff and it's just constant YouTube recommendations, kids shows, Disney stuff, you can just clear your home screen up right and just have your apps that are there. So yeah, it's a good way to cater to both. You can just toggle it on and off when you want. I personally will be keeping it on because I think it's a good idea. You've obviously got Google Assistant built into this as well. You do have a dedicated Google Assistant button, which is actually your coloured button on your remote. If you press that, you can rather hold it and speak, or if you just press it once, you can just select the suggestions that are there for you. So browse comedy TV shows. And there we go. It's going to show you the most popular. There's a filter at the top. You can select which is free, which channel it's on, what category it falls under, etc. And it gives you loads of suggestions. Not only is it a way to manage your media, but it's just a good way to find new media as well. As I said, I would usually pull out an app on my phone to find this stuff. Now I don't have to do that. It's just all on the home screen. So performance-wise, this thing's brilliant. I'm not going to show you too much content because it just gets boring to do this in every video. But I will show you just how it works with a VPN. So for instance, if I want to enable my VPN, I've got all of these from the App Store. I didn't have to sideload any of them. They're just there. Works just as it would on any other device. It's as good as using the Shield, maybe a little bit slower, but nothing to the point where you'd be like, there's a huge difference. Gonna switch that VPN on, gonna quickly load up a service and just show you that it does work without problems for any UK people. And there we go, straight in there. And it's just working fine. The one thing that I will say is a little bit irritating about it is there is no double press or double tap to force close an app. To actually force close an app, you have to go into your settings and you have to do it that way, kind of like you would on a Fire Stick. So I'll just show you what I mean by that. You go into your apps here and you just go over to the top, force close it, and that's it. It would be nice if you could just double tap the home button and it would give you the option to close them apps like you can do on the Shield interface, but it's not a big deal. So yeah, to round it up, this device, I think it's brilliant. I think for 60 quid, you can't spend a better 60 quid on something that is officially Google TV. You're going to get official support for the apps that you run. As you can see, because I've turned my VPN on, it's now showing me different advertising options. So take that into consideration as well. If you do use a VPN, and I didn't even have to restart the device for it to recommend that. As you can see, these have all changed now. So that's a good suggestion as well. For instance, there we go, NBC. It's going to show me the price of these in dollars because I switched the VPN on. But yeah, a great device. I would recommend it to anybody looking to replace a Fire Stick, especially considering you can get this thing wired up to a LAN cable and get your internet running really well. You can't do that on a Fire Stick without having to use a big bulky dongle. A side note, I did read on Reddit that since they put an update out for this device, that USB hubs have stopped working. People did have them working with third party Ethernet hubs that you could plug a USB into, etc. But I did read that since they put an update out, it stopped working. I wouldn't buy this and bank on it working. If it does work, then great. If it doesn't, then I have told you that it might not work. But yeah, definitely a recommended buy. For £60, you're getting a really good device that is officially supported by Google. You're going to get lots of updates for this, and I would definitely recommend to buy it. Thanks for watching, guys. If I have missed anything out or there's anything you need to know, then just drop a comment down below and I will reply to you when I can. Cheers.